Mary Beth Chalk, co-founder and chief commercial officer of BeeKeeper AI, joins me now. How you doing?
I'm doing great. Thank you for having us.
Fantastic. So tell us about BeeKeeper AI. I've heard about it. It's awesome. But why don't you tell us?
Well, Escrow AI is a patent-protected zero-trust collaboration workflow, and it's an application that enables data stewards and algorithm owners to securely develop and deploy AI. It's a workflow that integrates the security features of Azure confidential computing within the data steward's secure environment, and the data never leaves the data steward's environment. It's never seen, nor is it shared, and the algorithm intellectual property is never seen or shared.
And that's interesting, because when it comes to AI, you kind of need a lot of data, but you also need the actual algorithms. Isn't it hard to secure access to real-world protected data required by clinical AI?
Oh, after years of battling with contracting and approvals, I can tell you firsthand, it takes anywhere from 9 to 18 months to get approvals and contracting, and then the institutional review board can take as long as 4 to 6 and sometimes 9 months just to get approvals. It's hard.
So tell us more about how you enable computing on real-world data, but still maintain the security and privacy there. I'm an AI engineer kind of guy. How do you make those two work together, privacy and algorithms?
Well, thanks to Azure Confidential Computing, we can leverage a trusted execution environment that we can spin up and spin down inside of the data steward's environment. So once they agree to do a project with an algorithm owner, they're able to curate the data that's required for that algorithm, encrypt it, and place it into blob storage in their environment. And then through a secure control plane, the encrypted algorithm from the third party comes in, meets up with the data where they unencrypt in an encrypted environment, the trusted execution environment, and compute. But the only thing leaving is a mutually approved report that does not contain PHI.
So let me see if I understand this right, because this is the part where I started learning about BeeKeeper AI, and I was super impressed. Again, I do machine learning myself. So the data is obviously private because it's medical data. I'm trying to understand the analogy. Are you storing it somewhere in a shared location, but it's only not? Explain to me how that works again. One more time. I'm a little dense.
Good. No worries. That data remains in the data steward's secure environment, so in Azure. And once the data steward curates the data for an algorithm, it is encrypted and placed into blob storage, and then we stream the data encrypted into the trusted execution environment that is operating in the data steward's tenant of Azure. So that data never leaves the control of the data steward. That's the beauty and the magic of zero trust.
And that's like, it's like BeeKeeper AI is like the holding data in escrow and making it private, encrypting it with hardware and software, and then you're bringing the algorithms to BeeKeeper AI, and then that's how it's kind of working together. Am I getting this right? I think I'm understanding now.
You're getting it, but we're not holding the data. The data steward's holding, we're enabling them to hold their data and protect.
That's even better. I mean, because it's PII, right? So any success stories you can share with this?
You know, we recently had a joint press release with Novartis around rare disease. And rare disease, by its very nature, affects very few people. And so the traditional de-identification of that data has been virtually impossible because of the risk of re-identification. But they had an algorithm that detected pediatric patients that had a very rare condition that typically takes 7 to 10 years to diagnose.
Oh, wow.
And so with the use of the PHI, they were able to encrypt their algorithm, protect its IP, send it to this rare disease data set that contained 27 patients with the disease, 2,000 other patients, where it could run on the full protected health information.
That's amazing, because there's no way to anonymize 27 patients with a rare disease. This is amazing. Well done, my friend.
Thank you.
All right, and thank you so much, Mary Beth.